Hello and welcome to round two. I kept this hand on the play. I'm going to play an underground C. And I'm not going to fire off a qual therapy into nothing. Like, I have no clue what's going on over there. So I want at least a little bit of information before I start casting that card. I might even put this game to use first. Unlikely, but who knows. He opens with probe. Could actually mean anything right now. Everyone's jamming Treasure Cruise, so all the tempo decks are fully on board the probe plan, if they weren't already. And then the combo decks as well. Volcanic Island. Well, that's not surprising at all. Okay, so he's playing blue-red tempo. It's fine. Probe post. So the first probe probably found in the Swift Spear, or else he would have Swift Speared first. My first therapy is going to name probably Brainstorm. And then if he has a Daze in hand, that's fine. My second therapy can trade for the Daze. Let's take a look at this hand. Double Brainstorm, Delver, Chain Lightning, Monastery, Swift Spear. Well, that hand is just not going to be very good anymore, is it? Alright. So, I always take a snip my opponent's hands. It's really nice. It's like the same thing as writing it down in real life, only it's just a click. It's just way better. So, the remaining hand of Chain Lightning, Delver, Monastery, Swift Spear. I'm not actually sure what of those I'm going to take. I think I'm going to take the Delver. Swift Spear is good for sure. It's good to get a creature in the graveyard too for the scavenging use. Maybe that's a reason to take Chain Lightning. But no, then I can't even activate the scavenging use. He knows that I have the Pernicious Deed in hand, so playing the second Swift Spear is a little awkward. Like, I guess he just thinks he's gonna get to burn me out here. If his draw was exactly Daze, then his line is really strong, because there's no way I'm not slamming the deed here. Nope. I think we should just win, because we can pop the deed for one, and then play the ooze with the mana up. Depending on how this ponder goes, obviously there's situations where the cantrips all chain up real nicely. I was worried that if I took the second Swift Spear over the Delver, then he would just, like, play chain cantrips together with one Swift Spear and, like, hold the Delver back until after I'd already blown deed. Oh no, he's exiling his creatures. I think he knew that I had scavenging moves in hand. Okay, so, yeah, he's still gonna be in pretty good shape then. He's getting in so much damage here. This 6 damage, that's disgusting. Deciding how I feel about playing the ooze versus playing the brainstorm. I think I ooze. This is going to fetch a tropical. I'm just going to do this as a sorcery. Maybe should have waited on the use. I don't know. Like, now he can bolt it, which is pretty awkward. He's down to 4 cards in hand. He's pointing the bolt at my face, so even more awkward. Okay. Yeah, we were very close to stabilizing there. Next three cards. I guess we would have drawn one for our turn. Yeah, I guess that wouldn't have helped that much. Would have got another creature in the graveyard. We definitely got out treasure cruised. I guess I should have taken the Swift Spirit or the Chain Lightning, one of those two. I thought about it. Definitely thought about it. So, Thrag Tusk, really strong here. I think what I'm going to do is cut the Force of Wills, even though the Force of Will is my most like tempo-friendly card. Bring in both Thrag Tusks, Shave a Grave Titan, and bring in some Nile Spell Bombs. Now I've tried this before. This is like my third time facing Blue-Red Delver. And I think this strategy is okay. The last time I brought in Nile Spell Bombs, he was playing Snapcaster, and I don't think this particular build is, but I think just hindering Treasure Cruise is pretty strong. I guess we'll see. I guess we'll find out.